Hi y'all, Liz here again today, and we're still talking about training. Today we're talking about floor basics, the basics of cleaning a floor, and the things that you need to ask about, you need to know about, you need to learn about, you need to figure out what you do in your company. So I'm gonna hammer again just a little bit on the reason for doing it your company's way. Because floors is another one of those things that we all think we know how to do it the best way. We've been cleaning floors since we were 2 years old and we know how to clean. Some of us are insistent that sweeping is better. Some of us are insisting that vacuuming is better. We all think we know the right way. So I'm gonna hit on this one more time. It's more important that you clean your boss's way than that you clean the best way. Now, some of you are just gonna be irritated by that, but that doesn't even make sense. If we're supposed to be the best company, then why aren't we cleaning the best way? Well, a lot of times you will be, but you just don't know that yet. And your boss is going to be figuring out how to do it the best way for your company. So your company has a lot of different objectives. If you don't know what those are yet, find out. Your company's objective might be to do the most houses that they can possibly do in a day and give as much help as possible to as many people as possible in any given day. Your boss's objective and your company objective might be to do all of the pickiest cleaning in the whole city, the cleaning that nobody else wants to do, that nobody else can do. So perfect that even cleaning one toaster takes an hour to clean. Maybe that might be what your company wants to do. I don't know what it is. And every company is different. So your job is to do it the way your company wants because your company has objectives to meet that are not yours. All right, so hopefully I made my case on that one again. All right, back to floors. Floor basics, again, not doing it the best way. We're doing it the best way for your company, which is exactly the way your company wants it done. Now, sometimes your company will ask, hey, do you guys have any suggestions? It seems like we're getting maybe a buildup on this floor, or this isn't working as well as it used to, or blah, blah, blah. That's the time to give your advice or to give your suggestions or to give your ideas, any help that you might have, but not when it's unsolicited. It's not helpful then. Just do your job the way you're supposed to do it. If it's not working, then ask for help. Ask somebody to help you. Okay, the main things that you need to focus on when you're cleaning the kitchen are the edges and smears and the amount of moisture that you put on. And actually buildup. Buildup is a really big thing too. Sometimes it is a big thing, sometimes it's not. It sort of depends on what you're using to clean with and what the customer is using in between. But those are probably the four things that you want to look at. You need to find out, do we do the edges or not? How do we do them? What's the product that we use? Do we use a stick? Do we use a brush? Do we use a plater's brush, a tile brush, a grout brush, a fingernail brush, a toothbrush? What kind of brush do we use? Or no brush at all. We don't brush them. We use a microfiber and a stick, maybe. I don't know. Do you do edges or not? And how often do you do them? Do you do them every time, only when they get built up, every quarter, once a year, only when they're ordered? I don't know. But you need to find out, because if you don't know when and how to do the edges on your floors, you're gonna get in trouble for that. There's gonna come a time where you're not going to have done it correctly and you're gonna get in trouble. So find out. Also, how much moisture do we use on floors? Different floors are going to require different types of cleaning also. If you're talking about a kitchen floor, it's going to be different than a bathroom floor, although many times similar, and different than floor maybe in a family room. Your laminates are going to take a different type of cleaning than your tile floors. Your marble floor is going to be a totally different type of cleaning than your vinyl flooring. So you first are going to need to know what type of flooring you have and how do we clean this type of flooring. The reason why this is confusing is what happens is when we're getting trained, a lot of times you'll get trained on kitchen floors. And so they'll train you that on the kitchen floor, you clean it this way. But what if your kitchen floor is tile? And the next one is vinyl. And the next one is a laminate. Those three floor types can't be cleaned the same way. If you do try to clean them the same way, you're going to end up with one of who knows how many different types of problems. So you need to learn how to clean different floor types versus room types. So cleaning floor types, you need to be focusing on what product that you're using, how much moisture, and the tool that you're using. Sometimes you'll be using a flat mop, you might be using a sponge mop, you might be using a steamer, you might be using a brush, a duck brush, if you have tile with deep grout. There are a lot of different things that you could be using. That's what you need to find out. The moisture, the product, and the equipment that you're using for all of the different floor types. And there are at least 5 different floor types that you're going to be running into on a regular basis. So that's what you need to find out about. And don't forget the edging. Okay, final thing on floors is how do you dry them? Very, very important to know how you dry flooring. Different floors can dry different ways. Many floors can dry on their own. Tile floors many times can dry on their own. Many laminate floors must be dried. So it just depends on the type of flooring that you're cleaning, and you need to know, how do I dry this type of flooring? Okay, and also, one more thing I almost forgot. Colors. Different colors have to be cleaned in different ways many times. Doesn't seem like that would make a difference, but it does. A black laminate flooring is going to show different things than a golden oak laminate flooring. So you're going to have to treat it a little bit differently. All right, that's it. Basics of flooring. You got some good questions to ask. So my question to you today is, what is the question that you know you're going to ask first? Maybe it's about somebody's house, or maybe it's about a certain kind of wood type or floor type. What is it? What's the question that you really can't wait to ask? Okay, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.